Hey, A1C Davis. I'm with the United States Guidance Control Shop. We're here at Nellis Red Flag Air Force Base, and this is an ECA. It stands for Electronic Control Amplifier. It's a computer that uses our AIRS, our Attitude Heading and Reference System, puts all that together, the brain's operation, and all these wires that come out of it go to different systems. They kind of communicate with a lot of different parts of the jet. But this one specifically right here, it goes down here to this right here, and that is a gyro reference unit. And it's a spinning disc, spins super fast, basically uses its the inertia of it to kind of give you the gist of what the aircraft's doing and where it's heading. So I'll send you upstairs to my counterpart and they can kind of explain the rest of the system.
I'm A1C O'Mara with the 96 AMU Guidance and Control Troop. I'm gonna tell you about our HSI and our ADI. This is our ADI, the Attitude Directional Indicator. It shows the aircrew a reference to the ground that they're traveling at. It also shows some pitch command steering bars and some roll command steering bars that also help guide them with how they need to travel. This is our HSI, the Horizontal Situational Indicator. It shows the bearing to the aircrew and it also gives them course deviation indications.
And I'm Sergeant West. I'm a guidance and control craftsman. And today I'm going to talk to you about our autopilot system, which is our final component of our attitude and heading reference system. This component here is our autopilot control panel. This control panel is what is our aircrews use to turn autopilot on and off and control all the functions of autopilot. The autopilot control panel works in conjunction with our autopilot flight controller, and this component is what our aircrews use to maneuver and navigate with autopilot. All these components combined are what make AIRS the important system that it is, and this is only one of the many critical tasks that the 96 Aircraft Maintenance Unit performs to ensure that the aircrew get the experience they need at Nellis Air Force Base.